Good afternoon, good morning, good evening, everyone, and welcome to Diary of a Trader. This video is going to go over the effect of the pound in Forex markets. Now, the pound is one of the world's largest reserve currencies, meaning that other nations hold it against their own currencies in case there is something wrong with... it's a hedge, basically. It's a hedge. Most everybody holds the dollar. And why do people hold the dollar? Because they trust in the ability of the sovereign entity, the United States, to pay and remain solvent, and that's where it has value. Other currencies around the globe that are like that are the euro, the British pound, and the Japanese yen. Oddly, the Japanese yen is called the Widowmaker because I mean. It's going to collapse at some point, the yen, but everybody's been saying that, and people bet against it, and yet it still goes up. So that's why they call it the Widowmaker. And then you have the Canadian dollar is another reserve currency, and the Swedish krona, and you know, there's the, and then there's some others too, but the pound is a special one. I'm a huge fan of the pound. I don't know why that is. I just always have been. And in fact, if you were to say to me, listen, which currency do you think will survive the next 1,000 years? I would say the British pound. Why? Because it's already lasted around 2,500 years. In some capacity or another, that currency and the people on that small island have been through a world of troubles in the past. And that currency has remained, the pound sterling has remained. So yeah, I would bet on it. If they say the trend is your friend, then I would bet on the trend that the pound is going to go up. Side note, I was on Bloomberg Television February of 2019, and the host asked me about the British pound, and I thought that it was going to be one of the best performing currencies, if not the best performing currency of 2019. He thought that was kind of silly. He scoffed at me like I was an idiot, and I'm like, well, yeah, I don't know, but it is going to. I mean, he asked, what about Brexit? And Brexit is a big point, too. I mean, Brexit is a bigger deal to Europe than it is to Great Britain. Why? All right. Why is it a bigger deal? And everybody talks about how this is bad for Britain. This is the best thing in the world for Britain. And even if it wasn't, it's not that big a deal for Britain anyways. Britain is part of the EU still. But if the EU were to collapse, all right, let's say the EU were to collapse, you know, it was just about to fall apart. What do they do? What do individual countries do with their currencies if the euro weren't to work? They'd be screwed. The Brits don't have to worry about that. They have a sovereign currency. They have a reserve currency. There is no reason for them to give that up, and they're in the best position possible. So there's a reason why the euro has just taken a nosedive against the dollar and the pound, while the pound has had a nice recovery. And last year, 2019, here's the yearly candlestick. The top left chart is the pound. Look at how that has performed. It's beautifully. Granted, it came up in the last, you know, three-fourths or the quarter of the year, but that was forecasted that out, and I'm very happy and pleased with how the pound has performed over the last year. You know, you compare that to the euro, I mean, just miserable, miserable. 2018 was bearish, 2019 was bearish, just continuing to fall south there. Then you have the Australian dollar, same thing. We could look at the Canadian dollar and see how that has performed. Of course, we look at it kind of the opposite, but if we want to look at that from a yearly perspective, you know, the Canadian dollar also has not had the best time either. You know, this has been kind of a rough period for currencies all across the globe. And why is that? People are fleeing their currencies and going into other currencies, all right? All around the globe currently, there are horrible things going on currency wise, all right? You know, economic depressions and panic cycles are generated by two major events. And they occur around every, there's a panic cycle roughly every 80 to 92 years. And those are generated by a few things: famine, disease, commodity prices, or currency crisis. The next one that we will experience is more than likely going to be a currency crisis. Now, some of these things can go hand in hand, but you know, the pound, though, is one of the most resilient currencies on the planet. There is no reason that I would be bearish on that currency. So, you know, what is its effect in over other markets? I mean, let's take a look here at a weekly chart and see. Britain is a small country. It's a small country. It has a small land mass. It has a relatively small population. However, it has an enormous amount of influence, probably greater than most other countries that are of its size. Britain is kind of it's a fascinating country in history and people. But let's take a look here at the swing low that occurred in 2016. All right, that was the Brexit low. All right, that was after the people of Britain decided to leave the EU, and this is the activity that occurred. Now, people will say, well, why is this a big deal for everyone else? Well, was it that big of a deal? Let's take a look. So we've got this Brexit low here. That was in October. That was on October 16th of 2016. What happened to the euro? On October 16th, 2016. In October of 2016, where was it at? It was all the way down here. It was already at a low. And then actually through 2016 all the way down, it pushed even further south to trade lower before that big spike in 2017 occurred. So it's a pretty big spike lower. And people will say, well, you know, it should have been bullish for the euro, right? No, it wasn't. The euro collapsed and it fell down further south. It preceded the drop of the pound, and we saw it really not have a recovery until, you know, 3-4 months later. People left the euro beforehand to go into the dollar. Really, we should observe, how did the euro pound pair trade during Brexit? Here's 2016, and here's the big spike up. That is a very understandable scenario that occurred, because what happened? What happened with people who were holding the pound? What did they do with it? Foreign entities, groups, and individuals in Europe, what did they do with the pound? They thought it was going to be bad. What did they do? They converted it, and converted it into what? They didn't convert it into anything else. They really converted it into, they took their pounds and converted them into euros. All right. Here's the joke, though. While this looks very bullish for the euro against the pound, the price action here, we need to take a look back at that euro chart, because something else occurred during that time. There was a rotation of sovereign capital in large quantities. Because what happened before this even happened, and actually during the entire process, was people left the pound, converted it into debt with the euro, but really everything was being backed by the dollar. And then ever since the end of that debacle, we've seen a very slow accumulation and change into the pound as a powerful currency. You know, we're looking at that right now on the daily chart. Let me get that up. Don't need that. It was a back test. The pound has had a fairly remarkable move here. Now, what do I think it's going to do? This is a little off topic, but if you want to reference the video later on, I'll show you something that is a phenomena that is in all markets. It's called a fallback pattern. Fallback pattern is nothing but the repetition of prior swing structure that occurs again. All right. And basically what I'm saying is that this move in the past that has occurred will happen again. If we start it right where it splits down the middle like a mirror, we should expect to see this type of swing structure happen again. We are already seeing it play out. That it doesn't mean that it has to follow it exactly. In fact, when it deviates from the swing structure. So in this case, if we see the pound instead start to spike low, or if it comes over here and starts to spike high, that's called a mirrored fallback. But a fallback pattern, it means that the same swing structure is being repeated. And the influence of the pound in the Forex markets cannot be misstated. It is one of the most important factors of all finance, and the pound and Britain itself is the center of finance on the planet. So I hope you found this interesting, a little bit on the pound, and look forward to speaking with you guys in our future videos.